Hello friends, today we will see a concept of isocircle in an isometric problem. In this problem, one front view and side view is given and we have to draw the problem. Many a times we get confused that where to place which view. So when we are drawing the isometric view, the views are just opposite. Let's start drawing this problem. First draw the isometric axis, for that one horizontal line and one vertical line. Then we will draw two 30-30 degrees inclined line with the help of some protractor or roller scale we can use. Here in this direction we will draw the front view and in this direction we will draw the left hand side view. Now measure the length 40 mm over this axis and make one square. Now mark the midpoints of all the four sides of the square. We have to use this midpoint to draw the isocircles. So we will choose the shortest diagonal first. And from that shortest diagonal we will connect the opposite side midpoint. We will take a radius from C1 to the opposite side and we will mark one arc. This is the half portion of the half circle. Then we have to find next center, for that we have to join opposite diagonal point with the opposite midpoint. Now with C2 center we have to draw one more arc and we will get the complete semicircle now. So this is the method how to draw the semicircle, that is the isosemicircle we can say. Now construct the diameter. Now similar construction we have to make for 20 mm besides this square. So again we will construct one more square which is 20 mm from each corner points. We will use the shifting method, we will shift the centers only. Now the backside square is drawn. Now we will shift the diameter by 20 mm. So here I am shifting the diameter 20 mm behind. Now it is shifted 20 mm behind. Yes, this is the front portion of that isocircle. Now we have to show this curve again at a 20 mm backside distance, so we will shift the center C2 20 mm backside. So measure the 20 mm distance, so now center is shifted 20 mm backside. Then we have to choose the radius which we have used when with the C2 center. So radius is selected and with the center C2 I am marking one arc. Now we will use isometric axis to make this part circular part. So we will construct one straight line over here. Yes, and it is the circular half portion. We will erase the extra part. Now again we need the second square to draw the semicircle and its midpoint. So this particular point we will use as center C1 and we will choose the opposite side's midpoint as a radius. these are the two radii which we have to connect with the help of one arc. So we'll measure the distance. This is the arc. So half portion of the upper. Connect this midpoint with the opposite corner point. Now this is as a center and this as a radius. We will make one arc. And here we will get the upper semicircular part. Now again we will shift these centers backside to get the same semicircular portion again at the 20 mm behind. So these three centers will shift 20 mm behind with the help of isometric axis in that given direction by 20 mm. All these centers are going to be shifted 20 mm behind. Now dark all the constructed lines to avoid the confusion. Now again construct one more square 20 mm behind the middle square to construct the remaining part. So here we are using shifting method. We are shifted the center and radius to construct the arc. Now draw a line parallel to the isometric axis. This is the half portion of the circle is completed. We will shift this center and radius 20 mm behind. We will draw the arc here. Is the arc. Now we have to draw the bottom arc. So for that, whatever the center we have used earlier, we have to shift that center and radius 20 mm behind. So for this we have used this particular center and this radius, so we have to shift behind 20 mm. Now it is shifted to the 20 mm behind. So this is the now new center and this is the radius that we have to take into the compass. This is the complete solution. Now we have to give the dimensions. The dimension should be parallel to the isometric axis. I hope you would like my video. Thanks for being here. Thank you. Do share and subscribe my channel.